الحمد لله وحده، والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده. أما بعد، we started talking about أفعال المقاربة and كاد كرب أوشك عسى. They are أفعال المقاربة and كاد and أوشك they have their مضارع form as well while others don't. And we said that it is essential for a فعل مضارع to succeed them. So after a فعل مقاربة, any فعل مقاربة, there has to be a فعل مضارع coming up. So كاد الطفل, so كاد, there has to be a مضارع, يقوم. Okay, so the child is about to, so كاد is near. مقاربة قرب, قريب, something very close to, so something which is about to happen. So كاد الطفل يقوم. A فعل مقاربة, as you could see, enters on جملة اسمية. الطفل يقوم. It's like كان. Same way. The difference is that in أفعال المقاربة it is necessary to have a فعل مضارع as part of خبر. Whereas with كان you can have اسم, you can have whole sentence, you can have جملة اسمية, جملة فعلية, مضارع, whatever, even ماضي, all would go. And so فعل مضارع with فاعل, which is most often a hidden pronoun, forms جملة فعلية and then constitute the خبر. So يقوم. يقوم. So becomes a complete sentence. الطفل يقوم. كاد الطفل. اسم of كان. Of كاد. And يقوم is the خبر. Okay, so the اسم of فعل مقاربة, الطفل, is in حالة الرفع, which is مرفوع. Nominative case, while the khabar is in halat al-nasab. So fi'l yaqum, this is in mahallan, in the state of nasab. Sometimes the particle an is used with the fi'l mudari of awshaka in asa. So asa an takrah. Okay. Asa an yaquma. Asa zaydun an yaquma. عسى أو أوشك, they can after the after عسى أوشك فعل مضارع can precede the اسم. So when كاد it has to be اسم then فعل مضارع. When عسى أوشك it can be before the اسم. عسى أن يقوم زيد, you can do that way as well. With كاد you can't, it has to be in that order. كاد إن خرب, it is better to use without an. So, although sometimes you can have that. Then we talk about أفعال الشروع, the verbs with which the sentence starts. All of these mean begin, about to. أنشأ, بدأ, أخذ, قام, جعل, طفق, شرع. So they all mean they're about to. But they do not get any an after that. They all mean to begin, to start, about to start. أخذ الطفل يمشي, the baby started walking. Began walking. Then أفعال المدح والضم. So أفعال المدح, مدح is to praise, ضم is to denounce or denigrate someone, to dispraise. When you praise someone, you say نعيمة or نعمة. Originally it was نعيمة, but you say نعمة. And bi'sa is ba'isa. So we use it as ni'ma and bi'sa. The fa'il is most often mu'arraf bil-lam, having al. Yeah, that's what mu'arraf bil-lam means. Or a noun that is mudaf toward mu'arraf bil-lam. Any of those situations. The fa'il of ni'ma. After the fa'il, another noun appears and it's called maqsood bil-dham or maqsood bil-madha. Mean the one who is the object of this praise or dispraise. It's called maqsood, which is the target of the praise or target of the dispraise. So if we say ni'ma rajulu khalidun, Khalid is a good man. So ni'ma, good man is the man, the good is the man Khalid. So ni'ma rajulu, so after ni'ma comes the fa'il of this ni'ma, and khalidun is maqsood bil madh, because we have making him, we are praising him, yeah? خبر مقدم, مقدم, and مبتدأ is مؤخر خالد here. بئس غلام الرجل عاصم. عاصم is an evil servant of the man. So فيلزم مضاف مضاف إليه مضاف إلى معرفة مضاف مضاف إليه. It becomes فاعل of this بئس فعل. Yeah, فيلزم فيلزم. And you have عاصم as مقصود بالذم. The object of the disgrace. So خبر together and this is مبتدأ مؤخر. Sometimes the word ma takes the place of fa'il. Sometimes we don't bring the bi'sa rajulu, bi'sa ma. You can just say bi'sa ma. Ni'ma ma. Okay. And the meaning here is of this ma would be shay'un. Okay. So example is ni'imma hi. In the Quran it says ni'imma hi. It was actually ni'ma ma hiya. Ni'ma, good. Ma, shay, thing, in the name of thing. Good thing is it. This is a good thing. That is a good thing, yeah? Ni'ma hi. Ni'ma hi is ni'ma ma hiya. Okay, this is how it's used in Quran. Sometimes an indefinite noun, nakira, in the accusative nasab state, takes the place of fa'il. So نعم رجلا خالد. Okay, خالد is a good man. In this case, a personal pronoun هو is hidden in the verb نعم. And this personal pronoun is the فاعل. And that رجلا is the تمييز and is therefore منصوب. I mean, this is a little bit deep. But if you couldn't recall it or couldn't understand this, not a big deal. It will be covered later on. When you do tarkib to try to figure out the state of each word in the sentence and what is their status and why that is. So why rajulan? Even if you say rajulan is in place of fa'il, which we know it is, apparently, because after ni'ma should be a fa'il, a doer, and then khalid is the maqsood bi madh here. So the target, the object of the praise. So why this rajulan is mansoob? So they will say, and ni'ma is actually the praise word, yes, but there is a file which is hidden, which is mahzuf, which is huwa, which is hidden inside ni'ma. Every verb has a file. So that huwa in this ni'ma is the file. This is rajulan is the description of that individual. Because when you say, what a good Khalid, what a good what? In what way Khalid is good? What a good is he, Khalid? What? Good in what sense? So there is this ibham, there's this, dubiousness, unclarity. There's something which is missing here. So you're saying Khalid is good, there has to be in certain respect. What do you mean the Khalid is good? In what way? As a person? As a doctor, as a patient, as a student, as whoever, whatever you are praising him for. So you say, oh, what a good man he is. Fine. So then you have to bring that. It's called tamyiz. Tamyiz is something which would clarify the doubt. Something which is not clear, it just clarifies that. So that's why ni'ma huwa rajulan khalidun. So the rajulan is mansub because tamyiz is mansub. Tamyiz is something which, clarifies something, deciphers something for clarity. So the verb together with this file is huwa in this case, and tamyiz forms a jumla fi'liya. Okay, ni'ma huwa rajulan. And also form the khabar muqaddam. Khalid is maqsood bil madha. It is mubtada mu'akhar. And mubtada and khabar together constitute jumla ismi. This is how you do the construction, the tahleel, the analysis, tarkib, we call it. Sometimes maqsood bil madha and maqsood bil dham, the object of praise and dispraise are eluded, are not mentioned because the context is very clear. For example, you would say, ni'mal abd. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about Ayyub alayhi salam in the previous ayat, and then say, ni'mal abd. What a brilliant slave. So who Allah is referring to is already there in the context. So نعم العبد أيوب. أيوب has been discussed. So he is the مقصود بالمدح here. And you would also read in the Quran نعم المولى ونعم النصير. نعم المولى. What a great supporter, what a great master, what a great helper. Who is, so it is clear that you're talking about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because the previous ayat refers to it, and then it's clear anyway. It's known fact. So many a time you would just not mention the maqsood bil madha or maqsood bil dham, because it is automatically clear. The feminine form of ni'ma is ni'mat. Bi'sa is bi'sa. Should be is actually. So ni'ma mudhakkar, ni'ma mu'annas. So ni'matil ibnatu fatimatu wa bi'satil mar'atu ghadiratu. The names. So what a good girl Fatima is. Fatima is a good girl. And bad woman is, bad lady is ghadira. Name. The remaining word forms of these two verbs are not used. You do not get further forms. Mudhakkar muannas singular form. That number of the five, whether singular, dual, or plural, does not have any effect on these verbs. They stay the same. So, okay. And there's another verb, habbada. Habbada is also used with the same meaning as ni'ma. And in poetry, they use habbada as well a lot. And while the la habbada or sa'a, wasa'at masira, Quran use a lot, sa'a, is the same as bi'sa in negative sense. So habbada al-ittifaq wa la habbada al-ikhtilaf. Unity is good and differences are bad. Ikhtilaf, difference is bad. Habbada being something which is good. The word habba is a verb of the past tense, as you know, and the is an indicative pronoun. It's called ishara. Ha, the lika, the ka. That's the indicative pronoun. It's ishara. And habba, as you know, is from the habba, from love. And it is a fa'il. The is the fa'il. The succeeding word is the maqsood bil madh. Likewise, the word sa'a, to be bad or evil or spoil, is also used like normal verbs, and its paradigm is similar to qala yaqul sa'a yasu'. It would be this word used as a normal bad with the meaning same, it's used as a verb as well rather than a fa'il bil madh. Okay, so that is the stuff for today. Let's just move on to the next lesson. Let me get the slides. Let's cover some of that and hopefully. Again, so we just covered this. How kada karaba afale muqaraba, and then you have awshaka asa as well with certain differences, and then afale shuru we talk about what they mean at the beginning, something that is starting, that's happening. Afale madh wa dham, ni'ma and bi'sa, mostly it has a mu'arraf bil lam or mudhaf ila mu'arraf bil lam, and this is how you construct it. And sometimes you just say ni'ma, sometimes you elide that maqsood bil madha or maqsood bil dham. When you have a nakira, it means that there is a fa'il which is hidden in the verb itself. And this radulan or the word after that, which is nakira and mansub, is actually the tamyiz of that. And the context would clarify if you remove that maqsood bil madha or dham. And then habbada and bi'sa, sa'a, habbada and sa'a or la habbada are used as well to mean the same thing. Okay. Sighat al-ta'ajjub. These sighatani ta'ajjub. So mudaf, you remove that noon of تثنية صيغتان two صيغات of تعجب تعجب surprise and indicate surprise yeah astonishment so there are two of them so هذان صيغتا التعجب دي لا two صيغات of تعجب what are they ما أفعله and أفعل به on this scale ما أفعله that's a scale أفعله and أفعل به these are the two scales that is used and these two are used okay ما أفعله and أفعل به remember that ما أحسنه أو أحسن به how beautiful it is ما أحسنه literal meaning what good has he done he has done it good but this is not how you translate you just say how beautiful how good it is أو أحسن به same word same meaning is amr do good with it but you don't use it in that literal translation it means how beautiful it is استعجب similarly in place of a pronoun who or he all the other pronouns and every type of noun which is مظاهر can be used whether the noun is masculine or feminine whether it is singular dual or plural no change occurs in these word forms Okay, ما أفعله and أفعل به, they remain the same. But after that, you can bring whatever. It doesn't change. So for example, you would say, أحسن برشيد أو ما أحسن رشيد. How handsome is Rashid? How good is Rashid? So you could say, أحسن برشيد. أو you could say, ما أحسن رشيد. Rashid is very good. ما أطول الرجلين. How tall are those two? أفعل remains the same. أقصر بالنساء plural, feminine, all same. You do not change these two formulas. The scale remains the same throughout. But you can add whatever you want to add afterwards. Okay. أقصر بالنساء. How short the women are. Okay. ما أحسن رشيد. So let's just dissect it. The literal meaning of ما أحسن رشيد is what thing has made رشيد handsome, ma ahsana, what has made him, made Rashid good? As if, out of surprise, we are asking ourselves the question. But we actually mean that, how handsome is he? So you're just, you know, surprised to the goodness of Rashid. Ahsin bi Rashid, literally mean regard Rashid as handsome. Amr, this is Amr, ahsin, making good. Rashid is so handsome, everyone is being commanded to admit this fact. The particle ba is extra in this expression. You do not translate that. Now, the verb kana is inserted for the past tense, while yakunu is used for the future tense. Ma kana ajmala manzara riyal. How beautiful the scenery of the gardens. Yeah. Riyadh is plural of rawda. Rawda means garden. Ma kana yakunu atyaba manzar al-bahr. How excellent the scenery of the sea will be if you want to make it in future. Kana or ma yakunu. Sorry. The second one is Mayakun. Mayakun. These word forms cannot be used for Thulasi Mazid or Rubai. Nor can they be used for thulasi mujarrad if the letter has the meaning of color or defects. Because they have similar form, there will be a problem, isn't it? The meaning of surprise can be created by these categories by inserting the following words before the verbal noun, masdar. You could just use ashad, ashdid, a'zam, a'zim. You can use these words and then use the thulasi mazidi or rubai. Yeah, and rubai mazid. You can use those مصادر and before that أشد or أشدد or أعظم or أعظم similarly. But you have to use these words because أفعل is the scale that you have to stick to. ما أفعله or أفعل به. So if you wanted to say how the people honor the ulama, wow, that's amazing how they honor the ulama. If you wanted to say that, you say, ma ashadda i'izaz. I'izaz is the masdar, honor. But you can't make i'izaz, which is if'al, on af'il bi or ma af'ala. If you did that, it would not be seen as sulasi mazid fi. It would be same scale as sulasi mujarrad. So you just use the same masdar of mazid fi, but ashadda or a'zama, you use in the beginning to give the same feel of ta'ajjub, the surprise. A'zim bi musabaqat al-mubathiri ila al-faqr. So a'zim bi, yeah? How rapidly the extravagant person moves towards poverty. Musabaqa, to compete. Mubathir, wasteful, spendthrift. Ila al-faqr, how quickly he is going towards his faqr, that is wasting everything. ما أعظم حمرة وجنة الإبنة. How great حمرة, yeah? How red is the girl's cheek. ما أشد عمل جاهل. How blind is the ignorant one. How severe is the blindness of this ignorant. So you use those words, أشد or أعظم, to make it, you know, emphasize and تعجب sense. So ما أحسن رشيدا, ما اسم تعجب المبني محلا مرفوع لأنه مبتدا. أحسن الفعل الماضي المبني على الفتح فتعد أنفسي. الضمير هو المستتر راجع إلى ما هو is hiding in it going towards ما. فاعل is the ضمير is the فاعل محلا مرفوع. رشيدا المفعول منصوب فعل مع فاعل والمفعول جملة فعلية خبرية محلا مرفوع مبتدا خبر together become جملة اسمية. أحسن برشيد likewise فعل أمر بالتعجب المبني على السكون الضمير أنت المستتر راجع إلى ما فاعل محل مرفوع حرف الجر ب زائد مجرور رشيد معنى منصوب مفعول منصوب المحل بالتعجب مع الفعل والفاعل مع الفاعل والمفعول جملة فعلية. Okay, let's just translate few of those. Let's see how much. Okay. ما هؤلاء الأولاد ما أحسنهم. What a good boy these are. These are really good boys. ما أحسنهم. ليس هذا الخيار ما أردأه. How bad are these cucumbers? ما أردأه. They're completely ready. Ready means completely useless waste. نعم الصدق ونعمة عاقبته وبئس الكذب وبئس عاقبته. صدق, truthful is good, and what a good outcome of it. وبئس الكذب, and what a kid is, what a bad thing. Lying is bad, and what a bad outcome of it. عاقبة. حبذا إطاعة الوالدين ولا حبذا عصيانهما. Obedience to parents is good, whereas their disobedience is not. سأت المرأة سلمى ما أقباحها. سلمى is bad. How bad is she? ما أقباحها. So they use أفعال مدح in the beginning, أفعال ذم there as well, بئس ساء. And then they make it into surprise, which is أفعال التعجب. So صيغة التعجب is used as well, making it even worse. ما أسبق الفاسق إلى مقت الله. Fasid, the transgressor, how quickly he runs to the displeasure of Allah, anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ما أكبر مقت الله على المشرك. How great is the anger of Allah over the upon the mushrik, the idolater. ما أحسن هذه المرأة وما أقبح تلك الابنة. How good is this girl, this lady, and how bad is that, how ugly is that girl. هذا الكتاب سهل. This book is easy. وما أسهله. How easy it is. Very easy. وتلك الكتب صعبة. Those books are very difficult. وما أصعبها. And how difficult are they. نعمة الناقة القصوى. ما أجودها. قصوى يعني قصوى is the name of the camel Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم used to ride. So how good is قصوى? It's very good. قصوى is very good. ما أجودها. How جيد is that? She's very very good. ما أشد تكريم العلماء وما أعظم تذليل الجهلاء. How great is the honor of ulama scholars and how great is the dishonor of ignorance. نعم الولد أنت وما أحسنت. You are a good boy. نعم الولد أنت. You are a good boy. وما أحسنت. How good are you? Be very good. أعظم بعلمي وأشدد بجهلك. So you, ilm, the knowledge is great. So his knowledge. أعظم بعلمي. His knowledge is great. And your jahl, your ignorance is greater. It's great. Means you're very jahil and he's very alim. He's very knowledgeable. نعمة الشجرة نخلة. Palm tree is good. It's a very good tree, the palm tree. ما أشد حمرة الشفق البارحة. The redness of the horizon yesterday, last night, was very how red. It's very, very red. ما يكون أعظم إبداد نور القمر في الليلة الرابعة رابع إيش من رابعة عشرة. ما يكون أعظم. So how good it will be the whiteness of نور القمر. See, so أعظم. They use إبداد إفعلال from that باب. So how right, the light of moon would be on the night of 14th. 14th, as you know, 14th is the, you know, the full moon night. Full moon night. المداد في هذه الدواء أسود مداد the ink in this الدواء دواء is in pot so مداد in this pot is black ما أشد سواد how black is its color I mean how dark the color is it's very very black سرني ما سمعت what I heard made me happy وساءني ما رأيت what I saw made me unhappy ألا حبذا عضال الشري في الهواء ولا حبذا العاذل الجاهل so, ألا حبذا be aware حبذا good is the one who did what عضال الشري في الهواء The one who excused me in my love. I mean, the one who excused me for my love because I'm doing all those funny, crazy stuff. So he, you know, this is one of the unusual words. So he excused me, fil hawa for my love. In my love, I'm just being completely crazy. My mind is not in place. وَلَا حَبَّدَ الْعَادِلُ الْجَاهِلُ And the one who does the عَادِل, عَادِل is someone who reproaches me for my crazy acts out of love, is جَاهِل. So he's not good, he's bad. Okay, let's leave it there, inshallah. See you next week. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.